Recently, I flew to Japan. Japan is a fascinating country, home to some of the densest cities in the world, with a booming industry and a culture people all over the world want to discover. Japan has also faced many cases of climate change disasters. Something's gotta change. That's what I went to see. What I wanted to learn about is their decisive step towards one solution, hydrogen. Hydrogen is the smallest, most abundant molecule in the universe. What stars are made of? Japan has decided to champion hydrogen in their fight against the climate crisis, and I really want to understand why. How could something so simple be Japan's answer to the most complex question ever? Seeking answers, I went to the city of Fukushima, where Japan is healing, and where it has swapped its nuclear plant for the largest renewable hydrogen plant in the world. Not far from where the disaster happened, FH2R generates up to 107 kilos of hydrogen per hour, using solar panels covering a surface area the size of 25 soccer fields. It will deliver hydrogen to the Fukushima and Tokyo metropolitan areas. I met with Eiji Ohira, a man who spent 30 years focusing on new energies, in particular, hydrogen. He is the director of the New Energy and Industrial Technology Development Organization. I had the opportunity to ask him a few questions, starting with, what is hydrogen?
日本が水素に取り組んだのは古くてですね、古く遡れば1974年になります。長年研究を続けてきて、日本にとって水素なんですけども、日本が抱えるエネルギー、環境、こういった社会的な課題に対応するための鍵になる重要な技術です。
He told me that hydrogen could be produced in several ways, from natural gases to renewable energies.This way, can we not only create hydrogen with no carbon byproduct, but we can also solve the main issue of renewable energies, availability or intermittency. Why? Because hydrogen is an energy carrier, and extra energy from a particularly sunny day can be stored with hydrogen.
まあ、水素というのはですね、再生可能エネルギーと組み合わせることによって調整力を提供し、再生可能エネルギーが持つポテンシャルというのを最大限使うことができます。
So green energy stored for later. An energy with many applications, including fuel cells, heating, powering industries, and so on.Still, you'd expect enthusiasm from someone so passionate about hydrogen.I went back to Tokyo, where in the last few years, voices arose for those hoping for a better tomorrow. Kiko Network Director Takako Momoi is one of the most prominent voices in Japan. After 20 years fighting for the climate, she felt she had more reasons than ever to be an environmental activist.
そうですね。気候変動に関しては、最近日本でも非常に豪雨があったり台風が大型化したりとか関心持ち始めている人は多くなってきていると思うんですただその問題とエネルギーの問題とがリンクしている人が少ないっていうところがやはり大きな問題なのかなと思ってますそれは脱炭素社会に向かっていないという意味で問題だと思っています
Takako feels strongly about climate changeShe's critical about the Japanese government's energy strategy and thinks it's not moving away from fossil fuel fast enough. But she confirmed there was potential in carbon-free hydrogen.
水を使って水を電気分解させていくっていう形での水素があると思います。で、それは完全に脱炭素の方向性に合ってると思うので、私たちとしてはそれは推奨されるべきだと思っていますけれども使った電気として余った再生可能エネルギーを水を電気分解してそれで使うという形の水素の方向付けとしてはいいと思っています。
So, what can we do with hydrogen? How can it be used? Fuel cells. In the Aichi Prefecture, there's a man who was the engineer behind the Toyota Prius plug-in. Now, Yohikazu Tanaka is chief engineer of the Toyota Mirai, which means future in Japanese.
そしてこの燃料電池乗車の特徴でありますが、一言で言うとですね、普通の車のように排気ガスは一切出しません。出すのは水だけです。
Only water? But how do they work?
でそれはどういうことかと言いますと、この車の作動の原理はですね、空気中の酸素と、燃料タンクに積みました水素を化学反応させまして、その結果発電した電気を使ってモーターで走る電動車両になります。従いまして一切排気ガスは出ませんし、
Hydrogen cars are electric cars that do not rely on a battery to move. They are powered by hydrogen generating electricity with a fuel cell. Tanaka-san explained that making fuel cells compact and high-powered was a technological feat.
それを使って走る車ということについてはですね、将来的にも環境に良い。加えてこの燃料電池システムは、このシステムを例えば2つ使うとトラックだとかバスも動かすことができます。トラックとかバスのような大きな、体格の車、そして航続距離を長く取らなきゃいけない場合においては、この水素というのは非常に、利便性が高いです。
Fuel cell electric cars have a short charging time, about 5 minutes, and a long range. That explains the hydrogen charging stations everywhere. According to Tanaka-san, hydrogen cars bind together driver convenience and environmental contribution. A way forward indeed.I came back to Tokyo one more time. I couldn't help but think about what I had discovered here. Is hydrogen the real solution? Could it work elsewhere too? And what is the missing piece to make it more widespread? I finally met with Monika Nagashima, an energy policy researcher who's worked for both the OECD and the Institute of Energy Economics in Japan.
また成功すればもうとても画期的な技術になりますので、協力しながら一方で競合する立場にある国同士がこれからどう力を合わせていくのかというのは、まあ、課題ではあります。
She seemed confident about its potential.
水素は世界経済の脱炭素化に一部貢献することはあると思います。まあ、そういったさまざまな技術を一緒に活用して脱炭素化を進めなければいけないと思います。国連の 1.5°C 報告書では2050年までに世界の CO2 の排出をネットゼロにしなければなりません。それはとても短い期間です。ここから10年、この先10年、CO2 を 45% 削減しなければいけない。この短い期間の間に脱炭素化を成功させるには、政府、民間企業、そして我々市民が力を合わせて前進を尽くす必要があります。
I left with a more compelling feeling than ever that Japan had quite the ability to offer a vision of what the future could beI've seen lots of new infrastructures providing new ways to use energy, from electrolysis to hydrogen refueling stations. New solutions to change how we live, how we travel. Can hydrogen bring about as much hope redefining mobility?